Welcome back to RPG Plus. We have some missions to go deal with Cerberus and places, so let's go do that.
Commander, I've got a hail from Admiral Hackett.
Put him through, Lieutenant.
Shepard, we've uncovered a secret Cerberus lab, function unknown. We sent in a recon team, but they were forced to pull out before they got very far.
Any other intel?
We think they're using the facility to warehouse and study Reaper tech. We've been wondering how Cerberus is connected to the Reapers, and this might give us some answers.
We're on it.
Find out what Cerberus is doing and get me any Reaper tech samples you can, Commander. Hack it out.
Will do. I brought the only two members I can right now.
The header up tracking some tech with a Reaper signature. That's your first sample to grab. Updating your nav point.
On my way.
Ammo tech on. Let's head up this way first. We have some right over here. That shouldn't have missed. But say, I thought there was stuff back here. Failed metagel experiments?
Will only lead to metagel advances for Hanar. Only Cerberus would call that a failure.
I think that's where we're supposed to grab. Adrenaline tree. Finally here, wow, the troops here are really intense. No one smiles, ever. And suicide on capture orders? Seriously? They call training integration. I start being integrated tomorrow. Can't wait. sure it worked out well for him. Let's go ahead and bypass this.
Well, that's weird looking. Guess we found it.
Yeah. Check some others real fast. Integration successful. Suicide on capture orders confirmed. Cerberus is my friend. Obey, protect humanity at any cost. It's like he's doing his own form of kind of indoctrination on them. Alright, we've drawn.
Got the sample.
Roger that. Meet you at the landing pad.
Maybe a little too sensitive for the slow motion now. Alright, we'll see how this goes. Second one. Here. So some movement out there.
Sleepers engage.
It appears to be Reaper tech, but the signature is new to me.
Here. Still got quite a few of them. They're like right there. Or some coming in. Trying to go around.
Stay focused. This isn't over yet.
I could do this all day.
Let's go this way to come out after him. Stealth is up. I'll have her place a singularity there to kind of pull them out. It was slightly too far. Flank Liara.
I'm on it.
There he is. Get her back up. Came to hold him back. Some above. There he is.
Stay focused and keep
I can't hit through. He's waiting to drop down. Oh, stay back. Got him, keep on him. Fast.
I hope he's still alive. You'll make it. Let's just keep the grenade. Landing pad clear.
Oh, close by. There he is. Ash. Stasis on him though. Go grab some ammo. Right there. Range for this. Nope. They'll throw it.
Best engineers looking at the Reaper tech you secured from that lab.
What was Cerberus doing with it?
We don't know yet, but whatever Cerberus is up to, it can't be good. Even if we can't determine its purpose, we've disrupted their experiments.
I doubt they'll just close up shop.
Agreed. We'll keep sending strikes against the facility. Good work, Commander.
All right.
Found useful information in the data you recovered, Commander.
Okay, this field kit can be used for a one-time upgrade to a variety of weapons to increase ammo capacity or the potential damage dealt. Well, we will be doing weapon damage.
Eden Prime. This is where it all began. Where the Prothean beacon gave you the vision that warned us about the Reapers.
And where you went up against Saren and the Geth for the first time, no?
Yes.
Yep.
And now, with Cerberus here, Eden Prime's colonists are under attack again.
Seems like more than just 3 years ago.
How bad?
A lot of dead civilians. Lost one of my men, Jenkins, to a Geth drone.
Reports that Saren had bombs set up to wipe out the whole colony.
Yep, he tried to.
Not on my watch.
Damn straight.
Cerberus hit Eden Prime hard. Whatever they found here was worth a major offensive. There are survivors elsewhere on the colony, but they killed everyone near the dig site.
Of course they did.
They deserve better.
I know. The Alliance did what it could to evacuate colonists, but Cerberus came in so quickly.
If we find survivors, we'll do what we can. What about this artifact? Is it part of the Prothean device we found on Mars?
The Alliance didn't get any specifics about what Cerberus has uncovered. But whatever it is, it's better off with us than with Cerberus.
I'm bringing you in as close to the dig site as I can.
That's a definite.
No way we'll avoid detection, but you should have a few minutes.
Understood. Alright, everyone. Get ready to move.
With luck, we can get to the dig site before Cerberus knows we're here. No sign of survivors. Come on, we need to find the dig site.
This was a beautiful colony once.
They came back after the Geth attack. They'll come back from this.
They rebuilt Mendoir. It wasn't the same.
They'll never forget. All we can hope is that they grow stronger for it.
Alright, this is a DLC that requires DR to go with.
Look at that. Bits of Prothean tech sticking out of the ground like an old bone.
Hey, Liara, you ever find dinosaurs while you're digging around?
No. Dinosaurs and other fossils would be paleontology. I'm an archaeologist. I study artifacts left by sapient species. The two fields are completely different, and... Oh, you were joking.
Hey, I just like dinosaurs.
Right then. Take that. We've taken more able-bodied men and women from pacified neighborhoods. Colonists generally have accepted the story that they have gone to perform tedious but safe manual labor in a service research camp on the other side of the planet. When we increased food rations as payment for work, most of the complaints died out. Maintain the story as long as possible. We don't have the manpower to fight the entire colony, and if these families knew they were never going to see their sons and daughters again, there's no way they'd cooperate. Damn.
Shepard, this Cerberus data could help the colonists still alive on other parts of Eden Prime.
How?
I can get this intel to Eden Prime's resistance. Maybe it will help them fight back against Cerberus.
Sounds good. Look for more of that then. Just loops around.
There. That's the elevator that leads down into the dig site. Goddess, that doesn't seem possible. It's not a Prothean artifact, it's... a Prothean.
You mean a collector? Those things the Reapers turned the Protheans into?
Oh, before that...
No. An original, unmodified Prothean, who's still alive.
You're right. That doesn't sound possible.
You saw Prothean stasis chambers in the archives on Ilos. The only reason those failed was a lack of power. Cerberus found this in an underground bunker. It still has power. He's been in stasis for the past 50,000 years, waiting for us. Think of what we could learn.
What can you tell me about the Protheans? The people, not the technology.
Given your experience with the Prothean Cipher, you probably know as much about them as I do. The Prothean Empire spanned the known galaxy. They uplifted countless other species to help them join the galactic community.
Uplifted, huh? Like when the Solarians helped the Krogan to evolve a little... faster.
Yes. Judging by the dig sites like the Prothean Archive on Mars or here on Eden Prime, the Protheans wanted other species to learn. It's clear that they prize knowledge, growth, and cooperation with the rest of the galaxy.
The way you describe them, they sound a lot like the Asari.
I'm certain I'm coloring their culture with my own perceptions. Whatever the Protheans were, finding one alive represents an incredible opportunity.
Good thing we brought our Prothean expert.
I hope I can help. If this single Prothean was sent into stasis, he could be the foremost scientist of his time, or perhaps the wisest counselor. Cerberus damaged the life pod when they excavated it. The life signs are unstable.
Then let's get him out of there.
No, breaking open the pod would kill him. We have to find the command signal that ends the stasis mode. We also need to figure out how to physically open the pod without doing more damage. Cerberus took over the labs nearby to research what they found at the dig site. That's likely our best bet.
Heads up!
Not gonna just let us walk right in. Sniper. What the hell? He is flying. Let's move in. Oh, right there. Sensitivity change when it comes to my pistol now, though. But I think I have it set up the way I'm gonna like it. Nothing here. Not really sure what part that's supposed to be. Resistance is heavy in the south and west sections of the colony. We've pulled most of our troops from the north neighborhoods to assist. Our remaining troops in the north neighborhood continue standard patrol activities to maintain the illusion of a large presence in that area. The locals knew we were understaffed. They could do some serious damage.
More intel to help the colonists. The more we find, the better chance they'll have.
That's... definitely want to improve their chances, so. Over here. Ammo. Alright, let's see to get in some high ground first. Get a look around. Nope. if you're gonna pop up on the roof. Oh shit. See him climb up. Where'd that grenade end up? Word from a source within Eden Prime's resistance movement that we can expect an attack on our security center between 2200 and 2300 tomorrow night. They're pulling in forces from across the colony. This gives us the perfect chance to destroy their leadership. Once the attack is contained, allow Dr. William Cambiata to escape, firing near-miss shots to keep it realistic. He's given us good information. With luck, the locals will see him as a daring hero and the only man to escape the Cerberus trap. They might even put him in charge.
Perfect. This intel will give Eden Prime's resistance movement a real chance to push Cerberus out of their colony.
Yeah. They definitely could put that information to use.
There. That lab found footage of the Protheans. Cerberus is studying it to figure out how to physically open the pod.
Oh, I actually have to stand here. So we go ahead and have the door open. Alright, there's just a level. It's the last version of it. Definitely noticeably different than the collector version of them.
How many have we lost?
Reaper forces have destroyed approximately 300,000 life pods.
And
third of our people.
Alert! Broadside bulkhead cannot be sealed. Hostiles detected.
Then all forces to the north.
I think I can duplicate that to open the life pod.
You understood that?
You didn't?
No. All I saw was static. Cerberus was trying to make sense of it without success. The Prothean cipher you received on Pharos, it lets you see the images as a Prothean would, and understand their language.
Whatever it does, I saw the video, and how they sealed the life pods.
Perfect. Then we just need the signal they use to activate stasis mode.
Still need a little more. This way.
They were gunned down while having drinks and watching the game.
Son of a bitch, this was somebody's home.
Spread the word. Sanctuary. Alright. Get some action. Oh, stop him. Sit over there, though. But he is destroyed. Liara, come on. Cool. Set up another one? Yes, they did. Damn it. Ah. Hey, Ara. Oh, she made it. On him for the moment. Why was Liara up there? Thank you. Come on. Turret. Got engineers. Prepare it. Shotgun. Oh. That was kind of a dumb move. Walked right through the fire. We have it now.
Found footage of the Protheans. Cerberus is studying it to find the stasis deactivation signal.
Might have actually been better to come in from this way. So a few more options. This way. Credits. Definitely need that ammo. Looks a lot like how we were seeing earlier. It's Earth.
I never thought our empire would fall. It won't. We will sleep here until the Reapers return to Dark Space. Then we will rise, a million strong. For the Empire. For the Empire.
But we know that didn't work. Stasis
port. Victory. Broadcast the stasis readiness signal to all life pods.
Guardians and the refugees who have yet to reach the bunker.
Their sacrifice will be honored in the coming Empire.
Game collector.
You understood that one too?
Yeah. I've got the signal the Protheans used to activate stasis mode.
Excellent. Then we have everything we need to open the pod.
Backup forces are here.
Of course they are. Let's see if we can flank. They're dying without me. Not over. It was. Singularity right there. Oh, fuck. Okay, you're back. we need some ammo. Apparently I've gathered from there enough times.
They've retracted the bridge. We have to find another way across.
Though. Any in here? There we go. Good there. All right. I think that should be enough ammo. Let's do it.
I'm transmitting the signal.
Perfect. It'll take a few moments for the life pod to process it.
Lots of bogeys inbound, Commander. We'll have to hold this position.
I don't particularly like this spot, actually. I just heard another grenade. Maybe not. Oh, guess I did. Jumping over. Carefully, Yara. Hey.
Looks like we've got a second to catch our breath.
Wish my corner man was here. I could use an ice pack.
Saw some ammo.
Has the life pod ended stasis mode?
There we go.
We're almost there.
If anybody's low, there's a Cerberus supply cache in the building next door.
I can lay down a singularity to block enemy access.
Sounds good. Atlas. Okay, heavy max.
Don't let it get close.
But let's get that singularity up there. As soon as I saw it, I should have done so. Coming in behind. And use this.
You can open the life pod now.
Now we'll do it.
It may take him some time to fully regain consciousness.
Guys are kind of crazy looking. Alright, dude, we're on your side.
Careful, he's confused.
Can you imagine being in that situation,
remember,
though?
It's been 50,000 years for us, but for him, it's only been
a few minutes.
No, the bunker is falling. There is no other option.
There are pods online! Those soldiers are still alive!
Their sacrifice will be honored in the coming Empire. Prepare a neutron bombardment. Get to your life pod now!
Until a new
shut off more pods. I need the few that are left.
Our needs will be triaged appropriately. You will be the voice of our people.
I will be more than that.
It's the only one.
How many others?
Just you. You can understand me?
Yes. Now that I have read your physiology, your nervous system, enough to understand your language.
So you were reading me while I was seeing...
Our last moments. Our failure.
It wasn't a failure, not a total failure.
Your people did everything they could. And never give up. And I could use some of that commitment now.
Shepard, whatever you did got Cerberus interested.
Asari, human. I'm surrounded by primitives.
It's not safe here. Will you join us?
You fight the Reapers?
Yes.
Then we will see.
A living Prothean.
That's correct, Admiral. But he's not quite what we expected.
Commander, our scientists barely understand what they need to do here. If the Prothean can help us construct this device, we need his cooperation.
Understood, Admiral.
We're losing colonies faster than we can evacuate. We've never seen a force like the Reapers.
He has, Admiral.
Can he help us?
I intend to find out.
Good. Cerberus slipped up and gave us a new weapon. Don't let it go to waste. Hack it out.
I'm sure Prothean wouldn't mind killing Reavers.
Shepard, I need you down in the port cargo hold. It's about our new guest.
I'm on my way. What's the problem?
I've tried to make the room more accommodating, but they're not letting me talk to him.
Apologies, Doctor. Contact protocol with a new species. Assume hostility. We had to dust off the regulations.
But he's not new. I've spent my life studying Protheans.
I agree with Liara.
At ease. I don't think our guest will be a problem. Will he?
That depends on you.
Calm down, people.
I can sense fear in you. Anxiety and distress. The Reapers are winning.
What do you mean, you sense?
All life provides clues for those who can read them. It is in your cells, your DNA. Experience is a biological marker.
Then what exactly did I experience back on Eden Prime? That was a hell of a flashback.
The battle left its own mark on me. I communicated this to you. It can work both ways.
Like your beacons.
Yes. Which... found one. You saw it all. Our destruction. Our warnings. Why weren't they heeded? Why didn't you prepare for the Reapers, human?
It's Commander. And nobody could understand your warnings. The beacon nearly killed me.
Then communication is still primitive in this cycle.
We pieced together what we could and used it to stop a Reaper invasion 3 years ago.
Then the extinction was delayed.
But sometime.
Now we have your plans for the device. We're going to build it.
Device?
The weapon your people were working on. I'd hoped you could tell us how to finish it.
We never finished it. It was too late.
Then I take it you don't know anything about the catalyst.
No. I was a soldier, not a scientist. Skilled in one art, killing.
What was your mission?
Among my people, there were avatars of many traits. Bravery, strength, cunning. A single exemplar for each.
Which are you?
The embodiment of vengeance. I am the anger of a dead people, demanding blood be spilled for the blood we lost. Only when the last Reaper has been destroyed will my purpose be fulfilled. I have no other reason to exist.
So I'd say you wouldn't be against joining us.
Those who share my purpose become allies. Those who do not become casualties.
I agree with that.
Then I'd say you found an ally. The goal of this ship is to wipe the Reapers from existence.
But how far are you willing to go to achieve that goal? I do not believe you, Commander. Lying is a biological marker. There is doubt behind your words.
We found this at the dig site. I assume it belongs to you.
It is a memory shard.
Could it help us with the device?
No. It contains only pain. But I will help you fight. And the last thing the Reapers hear before they die will be the last voice of the Protheans, sending them to their grave.
If you don't mind, I have a few more questions I'd like to ask.
Here it comes.
I've written over a dozen studies on your species. I've published in several journals that...
Amusing. Asari have finally mastered writing.
I'm sorry?
Never mind. What do you wish to know?
We've never seen a species with this sensory ability you have.
It was common among my people. Imparting experience through touch. The chemistry of life. Complicated ideas could be absorbed in seconds.
That'd definitely be helpful.
That sounds very useful.
We evolved as hunters. Reading 1,000 details in our environment ensured our survival.
I'm beginning to understand the beacons a bit more.
Mm-hmm.
Later, we developed technology to harness our ability. Information could be stored in certain objects through touch. Memory has its own biomarker, its own chemistry, as do knowledge and skills. The beacons could remember these things.
Things like Reaper invasions.
Yes, I can still sense the turmoil in you, witnessing the extinction of our empire. The fabric of your being was forever marked that day.
So, could you read something about this room?
There was liquid, a form of incubation, the DNA of a Krogan who lived here. He was powerful, prone to violence.
I'm impressed. His name was Grunt.
And if he were my enemy, I would have given him a wide berth. There is great strength in his genes.
Yeah, if he was a good asset to the team.
Liara here would never forgive me if I didn't ask you. What was Prothean civilization like?
Yes, I've always wondered. What sort of government did you have, and can you tell me about your religious beliefs, or perhaps the...
We are dead now. What does it matter?
I'm sorry. Studying your history has been a lifelong passion of mine.
When I was born, our empire was already at war with the Reapers. The first thing I remember was seeing my planet on fire.
Jeez.
What was your civilization like before the Reaper attack?
We were the dominant race of our cycle. We ruled the galaxy.
My studies indicated you were the only race engaged in space travel at the time. I always found that curious.
We were one empire composed of many subjects. All eventually called themselves Prothean.
What if they didn't want to?
They weren't given a choice.
Are you saying you enslaved the other species?
Any could oppose us if they wished. And if they had won, they would have ruled. Many tried. None succeeded.
I had no idea Protheans were so... severe.
It was by necessity. Very early, we encountered the dangers posed by machine intelligence. They rebelled against us.
We've had the same problem. They're called Geth.
We could not allow the machines to surpass us. It was decided the only way to win was to unite all organic life within our empire.
Did it work?
For a time. The Metacon War. We were turning the tide. Until the Reapers arrived. Then we understood machines had surpassed us long ago, in ways we could never imagine.
Back on Eden Prime, it looked like there were other stasis pods. What happened?
The Empire had fallen, and we knew our cycle was lost. We were the final vanguard, the best soldiers left alive.
So more of you were supposed to survive into this cycle?
Yes. Under my leadership, a new Prothean Empire would have arisen. We would have commanded the races of your time to prepare for the next Reaper invasion. But traitors within our ranks, indoctrinated agents, betrayed us, and the Reapers discovered our plan.
Just out of curiosity, how would you have commanded us?
By leaving you no other option. You would have joined our army, or faced the Reapers alone.
We've uncovered quite a few Prothean ruins. Were you observing our ancestors?
Before the war, we cultivated species who showed potential. Eventually, you would have been offered a choice to join the Empire. But when the Reapers attacked, we ceased all study. We hoped they would see you as too primitive to harvest.
Well, thank you, I think.
Well, that's kind of interesting.
Is there anything more you can tell us about this device your people were trying to build?
We heard only stories. They said our scientists were constructing a great machine that had the power to defeat the Reapers.
You never saw it?
By that point, the Empire was smashed into pieces. None of us knew what the others were doing.
Well, if we don't finish it soon, the same will be true of us.
What can you tell us about your own war with the Reapers?
Many of the details were lost. The conflict lasted for centuries. Those that faced the Reapers in the beginning were long dead when I was born. There were memory shards, however, passed down from soldier to soldier. They gave us fragments of what happened.
Several years ago, we found a Prothean VI that called itself Vigil on the planet Ilos. He was the caretaker of a research project.
During my life, Ilos was only a rumor. It was said we had cities there, built on the ruins of a civilization before us, the Inusanon. If our scientists did have a research facility, whatever they were doing was secret.
Yes, Vigil said they wiped all traces of themselves from the records so the Reapers couldn't find them.
The scientists eventually went into cryogenic stasis.
More of my people survived?
No, but they did stop the Reapers from taking control of the Citadel in this cycle. It delayed their invasion.
I never saw the Citadel. It was captured long before I was born.
And by them delaying it gave us time to delay it further.
How did your people wage war against the Reapers?
Attrition. We fought them system by system, planet by planet, city by city. Entire worlds were sacrificed just to slow the Reapers down. Time they spent harvesting a population was time we could regroup.
That must have cost you in the long run.
Yes. Our own people would be indoctrinated, converted, then turned against us. But there was no choice. Mercy is not a weapon. It is a weakness.
That shit with indoctrination is what makes them so mean as well.
Why do you think your own cycle lost the war?
What had been our strength, our empire, became a liability. All races conformed to one doctrine, one strategy. The Reapers exploited this. Once they found our weaknesses, we could not adapt. The subservient races became divided and confused. Then, it was only a matter of time.
I'm happy to say our cycle is different. Most races cooperate, but they still remain unique.
Then it may be your only hope.
All right.
Thank you for talking with me.
A lot of information about the Protheans.
Never imagined actually meeting a Prothean.
This has been amusing.
Oh?
To discover the most primitive races of my time now rule the galaxy. The Asari, the humans, the Turians.
There's also the Salarians.
The lizard people evolved?
I believe they're amphibian.
They used to eat flies. Commander, you may count on me. I am known as Javik.
Alright, good to have you aboard.
Need time to recover. The shock has not worn off yet.
I understand. This must be a hell of an experience for you. We're just glad to have you aboard, Javik.
Alright. I think with getting the Prothean, we will go ahead and end it right there. And next time we should be visiting the Turian moon near their homeworld. I'll see you then.